Hey guys, welcome to my channel. So today I would like to speak about my favorite author, Gabriel Garcia Marquez. A small preview about Gabriel Garcia Marquez. He's a Colombian writer and his literature fits into paradigm of magical realism. Magical realism means when it's create a perspective which combine such as things like past and future and life and death, opposite things through elements of fantastic, magical elements, something like this. And Marquez was born in March, now we are in March, and I decide to dedicate this video to my favorite writer. I think you know what is gonna be the first book. It is 100 Years of Solitude. The main theme of the book is family. In the center of the action is we see Buendia family. There are introduced to us like one of the first families which create Macondo. So Macondo is the city where the action of the novel takes place. The book represents seven generations of Buendia's family, and what it is good to know before reading the book, it is that in each generation the names of characters are repeated. For example, we see six characters named Aureliano Buendia and five characters named Arcadio Buendia. The author used this method to show us the immortality of the family through generation and emphasize the loneliness of this family. Each generation faced problems such as unfulfilled love, hatred, misunderstanding, envy and war. Through the linear events of Buendia's family, we see also economical, political and social progress of the city. We see the transformation of a small village with four families into a big town with a railway and huge banana plantation. With the sunset of the Buendia's family, we see also the end of the Macondo, this corner of the heaven. So, author wanted to say you that Macondo symbolized the land that you call home, that the land under your foot. This book best shows us Marquez's magical realism. For example, after the death of one character, we can see him speaking with family like a ghost and communicate with them like in the movie Coco. The main idea of the book is condition of human into eternity. For example, if it is possible for soul and for first human to survive through generation. The second interesting book is Love in the Time of Cholera. The story takes place in Colombia. The main characters are Fermina Daz and Florentino Ariza. The book starts with comparison of the smell of the fruit, which remind about unfulfilled love. Usually, Marquez's books introduced you in the middle of the story. It is like, you know about characters, you know about everything there. It is like ordinary day in the book. And this makes you to read very hard first 15 pages. And then, don't worry, all will be explained, so just keep doing. The story begins with a doctor. We see his life, we live his life, because he will be the tunnel which introduce us in the action of the story. We get out of this tunnel and we see who is Florentino Ariza, who is Fermina Daza, how they meet each other and how their love story starts. In the first level of the book, we see the description of this pure love, harmless love which touched the soul, young love. But in the second part of this book, we see the transformation of the romantic love into drama. How this love separates in two, like ideal love and depraved love. What love means for her and what love means for him. We see decades of lost love through unforeseen situation, like 622 affairs of Florentino Ariza had, and Marquez wanted to show us a different kind of love. If we speak about context, cholera, it is a disease, but this word used to show a deep emotion. So at the end of this book, you ask yourself, which heroes live the love like a disease, and which heroes live the love like a patient? It is good to read this book after 16 because there are some obscene paragraphs, such as rape and murder. So just go on after 18. Next book is Autumn of the Patriarch. Same style of Marquez, introduced in the middle of the story, now with a smell of important dead. The story takes place in Colombia, where a dictator was in power for several years. The life of this old man, this dictator, it is described by memories and fears of these citizens. In the first chapter, dictator created perfect clone for replacing him in public meetings, and before one attack, this clone died. Our dictator goes to funeral, to his funeral, and kill everybody, and he decided never die again. The book has 6 chapters. It seems to repeat each situation's betrayal by friends, the clash between society and dictator, and in each it is described how he stand up to everything. This book is hard to read because it represents a continuity of thoughts. Sometimes you don't understand who is talking, and sentences, last chapter, 50 pages, it's just one sentence. It is a different book from the rest of the books that Marquez wrote because in this book he approaches another kind of style to reveal the ideas. Marquez said that this is his main work, because if we watch from the political angle, each country has such a dictator. Even if he died, he lives through memories of our grandparents. This book is hard to read, but if you love Marquez, you should read this book. Guys, thank you that you was here. Thank you that you watched this video, and bye.